Corrugated steel is the most commonly used metal for industrial roofing. Corrugated steel roofs are lightweight, flexible, and easy to handle, install, and maintain compared to other building options. They are best installed on a slope to achieve adequate rainwater and moisture runoff. In order to maintain them properly and secure the workers at height, Fallprotec provides the flexible lifeline SecuRope on cold deck brackets, which complies with the EN795-2012 Type C and ANSI Z356.6. The system distributes the load evenly, being the best option for fragile roofs. The main components are end anchor with energy absorber, intermediate anchor, curve, end anchor with line tensioner, and cable diameter of 8 mm 3/8 inch and a glider as mobile anchor point. Complementary fall arrest anchor points can be installed to secure access to the lifeline from a ladder or to secure specific areas distant from the lifeline to avoid the pendulum effect. Fallprotec branch office in Hungary has installed 500 meters, 1,640 feet of SecuRope on cold deck with 28 complementary fall arrest anchor points in a factory in Moson-Zolnok, Hungary. The installers must wear the correct PPE, such as fall address harness, helmet, lanyards, and gloves. It is best to install the curves first if the lifeline has at least one of them. The components of a curve are 2 neo-intermediate anchors, 2 crimping rings, 2 cold deck fixing assemblies, 32 self-drilling screws, 8 strips of sealing tape, and cable diameter of 8 mm 3/8 inch. The components of an intermediate anchor are the same as those of one curve support, except for the crimping ring. In intermediate anchors, it should be installed every 50 meters, 164 feet, of cable lifeline. First, pre-assemble the main components of a curve. Install the neo-intermediate anchor on the fixing assembly IDF053. This bracket ensures a homogeneous distribution of the pull-out force on the cold deck roof. A simple and quick way to do this is by first installing the base of the neo anchor to the plate with the M12 bolt. Tighten the nuts on the backside with the flat key size 19. Then install the head together with the calibrated sharing pin. This pin releases energy by breaking in the event of a fall. Tighten the screw using the Allen key. Cut 4 strips of sealing tape of 11 centimeters, 4.3 inches each. Stick them on the 2 rows of screws that coincide with the 2 successive corrugations of the metal sheet roof. The distance of standard corrugated metal sheets on the market varies from 210 to 333 millimeters, 8.3 to 13 inches. For a lifeline longer than 100 meters, 328 feet, the distance between anchors is 12 meters, 39.3 feet maximum. Measurements can be made with sophisticated tools such as laser distance meters or levels for more accurate and professional installations. The minimum radius allowed for a curve is 400 millimeters, 15.7 inches. Measure the distances accordingly and place the plates, first removing the paper protecting the sealing tape. To install the IDF053 bracket, it is absolutely mandatory to use 16 IDF046 self-drilling screws or rivets provided by Fallprotec. The IDF046 self-drilling screw has been designed according to Fallprotec specifications. Pre-drilling of 4 mm, 1/8 inch diameter, is only necessary when the thickness of the metal sheet exceeds 0.63 mm, 0.025 inches. After pre-drilling, the installer must always clean the area thoroughly to avoid future corrosion of the corrugated metal sheets. The tightening torque should be adapted according to the cold deck roof. In all cases, ensure that the EPDM washer is compressed correctly, not too weak, but not too hard. The table in numeral 2.6 of the installer manual DOC 062 presents the data of the pullout according to the material and thickness. Install all IDF053 lifeline supports with anchor points, both intermediate and end anchors. Pass the cable through the cable guides of all the lifeline anchors. At the curves, add 2 crimping rings LDV011 between the 2 anchors inside the curve. The crimping of the cable starts with installing the end anchor with an energy absorber. The components are one energy absorber equipped with spring, one cold deck fixing assembly, one end anchor, 16 self-drilling screws, 4 strips of sealing tape, and cable diameter of 8 mm 3/8 inch. The energy absorber reduces the force transmitted to the host structure in case of a fall. The spring prevents overloading the anchors in case of significant temperature variations. Once the energy absorber is assembled, proceed to crimp the LDV008 ring 6 times. It is imperative to use a crimping tool supplied by Fallprotec to ensure a proper crimp capable of withstanding a force of 37 kilonewtons. Cut the remaining steel wire. The spring must be compressed to 40 millimeters, 1.57 inches, on mounting. Tension by hand and crimp the LDV011 rings directly onto the curves. The crimping of the cable ends with installing the end anchor with a line tensioner. The components are one line tensioner, one cold deck fixing assembly, one end anchor, 16 self-drilling screws, 4 strips of sealing tape, and cable diameter of 8 millimeters, 3/8 inch. A tensioning tool supplied by Fallprotec is used to tension the cable. A cable grab is fitted on the cable in contact with the plate of the tensioning tool. The cable passes through the hole of the plate. Place the tensioner LDV137 against the end anchor LDV002. The tension is sufficient to keep the cable stretched over the entire length of the line. Use a 19 Allen key to tighten the bolt and put more tension on the line. Verify the tension by measuring the compression of the yellow spring. The recommended tension is 100 kilograms, 220 pounds, equivalent to a spring of 100 millimeters, 3.9 inches, long. If the roof is fragile or the region has important temperature differences causing dilatation, Fallprotec allows lower tension in the cable. The table in numeral 8.3 of the installer manual DOC023 lists the allowable tensions. Crimp the tensioner 6 times. Remove the tensioning tool and cut the cable. Increase the tension in the lifeline by loosening the tensioner if necessary. Lifelines on cold deck roofs are often installed close to the apex for skylight maintenance works. This area is far away from the edges of the roof and the access ladders. Fall arrest anchor points external to the lifeline are usually installed to protect the worker when accessing the roof and to avoid the pendulum effect when they must carry out maintenance near the edge. The components for the installation of the LDV029 yellow eye anchor are the following. One yellow eye anchor LDV029. 16 self-drilling screws or rivets. One cold deck fixing assembly. And 4 strips of sealing tape. Pre-assemble the eye anchor with the M12 bolt in the bracket IDF053. Place the washers as they appear in the installation manual DOC037. The anchor must rotate freely. Pre-drill if necessary, then clean up the area. Place the strips of sealing tape on the 2 rows of screws that coincide with the 2 successive corrugations of the metal sheet roof. Place the support. To install the IDF053 bracket, use 16 IDF046 self-drilling screws or rivets provided by Fallprotec. The LDV029 anchor point complies with the EN795 Type A, the TS16415, and the ANSI Z359 18-2017. The NEO intermediate anchor is surpassable and enables the user to walk safely along the entire length of the lifeline. Test the glider sliding above the intermediate anchors and the curves. The components of the lifeline SecuRope can support forces without permanent deformation with a safety factor of 2 before breaking. The maximal allowable force applied to the intermediate anchor must not exceed 6 kilonewtons. The force applied to the end anchors on a cold deck roof must not exceed 11 kilonewtons for metal sheet thickness above 0.63 millimeters, 0.025 inches, and 8 kilonewtons for metal sheet thickness equal to 0.5 millimeters, 0.019 inches. If the force is greater, it will be necessary to decrease the number of users or reduce the distance between successive anchors.